We did Dixie, which is the South, and it's about 11 states. And the dark maroon colors is always included. The red is sometimes included. And I found that the striped states are sometimes included depending on historical connections to the South, like West Virginia, with the Appalachian Mountains running through them. This is how Dixie got its name. These are $10 notes called a Dix, which in French is 10, and then they were later on called Dixies, and then that is how Louisiana got its nickname, the Dixieland. This is the language that are prevalent in Dixie. The top picture, the maroon, is French that is spoken, which is the Louisiana French. And in the bottom corner, the yellow says that it's 6 to 12% French spoken in households today. Brown is 12 to 18%. And red is over 18% spoken in households today. This is religious. The Bible Belt runs through the red area, which is the Southern Baptist Convention. And how Baptists became prevalent in this area is in May of 1845, the Baptist congregations in the U.S. split over slavery and missions. This is who lives there. And in the top picture is a map from 2000, where purple is prevalent in black people that live there and white being the second. And then this map is from 2000 to 2010, where 50 to 100% population change from black to Hispanic.
The top map is the population in each state. The darker red ones are the ones with the higher population, which really is like Florida and parts of Texas since a little sliver's in there. The bottom map shows how their population relates to like their crime rates, which is really surprising because Louisiana was dark. And the next map shows the median age for the amounts of people that live there. And the top one shows it by each state, and the bottom one shows it by individual counties. And Florida is really the only higher one over 40 because of the climate, how hot it is there. And then, okay. The top map shows the counties in each state for how many slaves were there during all that, and the bottom map correlates to that by the African American population in those states, and this is kind of why like they're considered the Confederate states whenever you look them up. This next map shows the climate and the trees. The lighter green is like a broadleaf mixed forest. The bottom green is a coniferous forest, and right here is like kind of like Bretonian forest area. The top picture shows the underlying rock, and the Appalachian Mountains really like runs through kind of like all of it. It kind of separates it from the top, from where the foundry and all that is. The bottom picture shows the Black Belt, which relates to the soil, and it talks about how it's cotton plantations.
With this map, it shows the blue and like the teal color. That's the un-union states, and they happened with the deindustrialization, and that happened like in the 1930s. Another shift that came through was the Sun Belt, and that was from the Mexicans coming over in the 1970s, and that was because of the warmer climates and the ag opportunities. This is a picture of the red, the soft red winter wheat, which also is included in like cake mixes and pastries, and with the beer consumption, and that leads to the obesity, and other crops are like corn, cotton, and soybeans, and peanuts and tobacco. This is a picture that kind of illustrates what's going on. This is Raleigh, North Carolina, and it shows that the last two generations have really boomed with business, with taking like automobile plants from across the pond over to here, like in Volkswagen, they're coming over to like Chattanooga and stuff like that. And this is Winn-Dixie, and it actually happened, or a chain of grocery stores, and it developed in 1913 from two brothers. And in 1945, it was sold to Winn and Lovett, and that just boomed right from there. It was a big college supporter with the blacks, and it was just huge down in the South. This is a picture of the houses that are typically found in the Dixie area, with the big oak trees and the big wraparound porches, and it was more like family with a bigger yard. And this is also with the Dixie's boundaries are more defined with emotion versus like any other kind of nation.
here are some things that might relate to you guys more. These are popular and more well-known colleges that are in Dixie. We've got LSU, Alabama, the Gators, Florida, Duke, Texas Longhorns, Carolina Tar Heels, and Mississippi State Bulldogs. Football was more common sport known in Dixie, rather here it's more basketball. These are more professional teams. You've got the Saints, the Carolina Panthers, Dallas Cowboys, Dallas Mavericks, Tennessee Titans, Orlando Magic, and Jacksonville. Out of Dixie, Florida has the most amount of sports teams there. These are famous people that are from the area. You've got the Manning brothers, Morgan Freeman, Sandra Bullock, Ellen DeGeneres, the famous Pamela Anderson, Johnny Knoxville, John Cash, and the famous crew of Duck Dynasty. Also, people from there that aren't pictured are Vanna White and Martin Luther King Jr. These are people that have made history over time that were from Dixie. Helen Keller, George Washington, Robert E. Lee, Bill Clinton, Andrew Jackson, and Thomas Jefferson. A few others were Al Gore, George Bush Sr. These are things that you can do in Dixie. Florida had the most amount of things, which is up there in the right corner. You got Disney World, Epcot, SeaWorld. They also have the Daytona International Speedway, New Orleans, Scott Mardi Gras. In Tennessee, you can do Graceland, Opryland. In Carolina, you have the Carowinds, which is kind of like Kings Island to us.
Thank you.